Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We're playing the part of Wilbur, and here's Gulliver. He's going to stay here, and here's Nate. So Gulliver's going to watch Nate, who's his son, and he built, long story. And Gulliver's wife, and a little rat that's come with us. Esther and Timmy have been chased by a paladin who leaves no footprints, and a werewolf, among other things, perhaps. Look at the boards. Now, we've been here before.
Shop has been nailed up. I'm sure that a few little wooden planks like that wouldn't stop a headless horseman or a werewolf.
I doubt it.
Shop is.
We've talked to him before, last episode. We'll go talk to him again. We should look at his stuff again.
It seems the mayor isn't just the mayor. Fireman, priest, coachman, and blacksmith. Looks like he's also forced into being his own washerwoman.
Well, he needs someone to wash your clothes. We can take it. I thought there would be someone behind it.
Hopefully the mayor won't have any objection, as long as it helps me banish the evil from the woods.
Yeah, this will help us banish the evil from the woods. Maybe we can pretend to be a ghost. A little, ghost.
An old, let's say, you know, being generous, you know, charitable and all that, white bedsheet.
Excuse me, just making sure we can't combine any items here. It's not enough to simply drag an item onto another. Sometimes it's you have to drag that item here. See that? Press the bolt into the sand. Nothing happens this way. I don't know why we want to do this.
I could make an imprint of the bolt in the sand, but I'm carrying the sand in my pocket. The imprint will instantly fall to bits.
Wondering why we want to do that. Can we wrap the sand in this? No. Weird. Okay. So the only other things to do around here is to go inside here. Let's talk to him again. Maybe he can help us. At least give us a valuable item, which will aid us in our quest. Oh, he's sitting here now. Is he not that afraid? You don't need to be sitting in your circle anymore. Let's look at the crossbow again.
A crossbow is a devastatingly effective weapon. At least it is, if you manage to hit something.
Hey, I just sell the weapons. I don't know how to use them.
Statistically, if you have a crossbow in the house...
Well, statistics are made by people who don't live in a cursed village.
Okay, so I got this shelf back
I
here.
I don't think the shop is doing well. Sure, a motley selection of armor, weaponry, food, and magic posters always tends to work. But if the shop is stuck out in the middle of nowhere and no one is sending heroes to the area, then who's going to buy all this stuff?
Dunno.
The shelves seem to be... If I had more time, I'd love to rummage.
Alright, let's talk to him again. Help us, sir.
Hello?
Oh, yes?
What kind of shop is this exactly?
This is a traditional adventurers and hero shop, right?
Oh, absolutely. It was founded by my grandfather. He used to be very busy around here. Oh, there were giant spiders in the woods. There was an old goblin mine a day trip to the south. In the heyday of hero tourism, we were even thinking of building a sewer system. We sell armor, weapons, elixirs, provisions, ice arrows, antidotes, anything you need. And you can pay with spider legs, goblin ears, and things like that.
Oh, we're all out of that stuff.
And what do you do with those?
It's a trade secret. If you want to sell something,
eat them.
You can do it risk-free. I'll look after the object in case you want to buy it back later.
You what?
Oh, yeah. In case you change your mind later. Then you can buy back the same object for the same price. It's called the market economy.
Do you sell weapons for hunting werewolves, by any chance?
I need something I can use to defend myself against a werewolf. Do you have anything like that?
We've never been attacked by a werewolf before, so we haven't got any special anti-werewolf weapons or the like.
Nothing silver?
But as far as I know, any normal weapon made out of silver should do the job.
Right, so you do have
what's
one.
What's your skill? Sword and shield? Twin daggers? Gun lance?
You mean you can fight with two daggers at the same time without mutilating yourself?
Oh, so you're a long-distance fighter. Oh. Bow, crossbow, or slingshot?
Crossbow.
As amusing as it would be to use a slingshot against a werewolf, I'd pass on that. Bow or crossbow would be better. I've got a lovely composite bow, plus two in stock, but it requires dexterity 15.
I think I might be able to handle something like that crossbow.
What's your dexterity, Wilbur?
Yes, a light crossbow is easy to use and packs a real kick. Oh, any old fool can hit something with that.
What does a crossbow cost?
A light crossbow like that? How much does it cost?
3 gold, 7 silver, and 2 copper coins. Or I'll give you a quest.
Quest?
Ooh, what's the quest?
Bring me 10 wolf skins.
You just made that up on the spot, didn't you?
No, it's very important.
He's an NPC.
Sounds like a pretty generic task without any real purpose to me.
Pretty much.
You bring me 10 wolf skins and get a crossbow as a reward. What's the problem? I haven't got any silver bolts, though.
What's the deal with the crossbow and the wolf skins again?
So you want me to bring you 10 wolf skins for a crossbow which will allow me to defend myself against a werewolf?
Right. And while you're getting the skins, you'll gain some valuable experience that'll make you into a better hero.
But it's going to take forever to find 10 wolves. And I really don't want to strip the fur off them either. They need it.
Not if they're dead.
10 skins for a crossbow. That's the quest. And if you like, I can quickly think of a backstory for it.
Not interested.
A backstory. Can I bring my friends here? It might be safer for them.
My friends up there by the campfire, could I maybe bring them here? It could be safer for them.
You might be afraid of one of them, though.
Of course. Yeah, not only for them. The monsters from the woods might snatch one of them instead of me.
Right. Okay. I'll let Gulliver know then.
Gulliver? Isn't that the one who was beheaded?
Not beheaded. He just lost his head. Zombies don't mind that kind of thing.
No, he doesn't want him saying that.
I'm not having zombies in the house!
Nah.
Why not? He's lovely.
I don't want anything to do with their kind. Alive or dead, they should make up their minds. We want decent folk here in the village. Not ones cobbled together out of parts of decent folk.
Well, it would seem I will be helping you with your monster problem after all.
Yeah, looks like I'm going to be helping you after all.
How do you mean?
The curse? The woods? It looks like we have a common enemy.
Right. Right. I'll give it a go. I mean, I have more confidence in the bounty hunter, but I've reached the point where I'll grasp at any old straw.
Thanks.
Thanks. How motivating.
Exactly. How do I find the heart of the wood?
This evil heart of the wood. What exactly is it? And where can I find it?
It's a clearing in the center of the woods. There's an old dead tree standing in the middle of it. You'll recognize it when you see it.
I've seen it in the distance.
But how am I going to find the clearing? The woods are pretty big.
And confusing. The heart of the wood doesn't want to be found. It's whatever it is that's sending these creatures after us. It lives in that clearing. Oh, I'm quite sure of that.
Do you think that it might be the ghost of the Sorcerer Van Buren?
Perhaps. The elders did warn us. They said you should never mess with the sorcerer. They were scared and whispered of dreadful dangers. Oh, if only we'd listened to them.
Oh, well. Can't your ghost detector help me to find the heart of the wood?
Couldn't your device help me find the heart of the wood? Doesn't it detect ghosts and stuff?
Yes, I see. You're saying that nothing around here radiates more psychokinetic energy than the heart of the wood. You might be right.
Yeah, I agree.
You should get yourself a PKE.
You should give us yours. Why don't you give me your PKE detector?
I was hoping you could give me yours.
my detector? Never!
Hey.
It's my PKE. It's never let me down.
But if you give it to me, I could find the heart of the wood and lift the curse.
Yeah, be a good guy.
Or you might be killed and lose it in the woods. It takes weeks to deliver such a masterpiece of occult technology.
All right, give us another
quest.
That's
exactly why I can't hang around here waiting for another device. I need yours.
Forget it. The PKE reliably shows when anything supernatural is creeping about. And I have to know that.
Just bash him over the head and take it. All right, see ya.
See you again sometime.
I hope so. Really do.
So is this the one we're going to be questing for?
Mr. Whale will sell me a crossbow for 10 wolf skins.
No. I won't sell it to you. I offered it to you as a reward for a quest.
Even better.
And the quest is to get you 10 wolf skins.
That's right.
Yeah, it's not we give him 10 wolf skins and then he sells it to us. Come on, Wilbur.
The mayor wants 10. As soon as I have a crossbow, I'll need a silver bolt. Without one, it won't be much help against the werewolf.
Is the one we have silver?
A standard crossbow bolt made of
iron.
But a human hand long and very heavy. I wouldn't like to be hit by something like that. Unfortunately, completely useless against werewolves.
That's why he says
that. The thing that works against them is silver.
That's why he said that before. He had no reason to say it because we didn't know anything about any werewolves. I can't put the bolt in there. So for some reason we have to make an imprint with the bolt in the sand. I have no idea why. Alright, let's go. Maybe we can scare him by destroying these boards.
Shop has been nailed up. I'm sure there are a few little wooden planks like that, wouldn't...
I don't think we can do anything with this, but just in case. A washing line? We can see this before.
You can always use some string, as I'm sure I've mentioned on more than one occasion.
Okay.
It wouldn't be theft. I really need the string for, stuff.
Stuff.
The washing line does, however, seem to be knotted to a hook on the house, which is much too high up for me. I can't reach the knot tying the washing line to the house.
I can't just tie it and pull it. I don't know. Okay. Can we look at any of the stuff in here anymore? Nope. Alright, let's go see if we can tell Gulliver what we found. Found out.
Gulliver!
Wilbur, how can we help?
I asked the mayor if you could wait in the village.
I think you might be safer in the village than here. I asked the mayor if you could wait there.
Of course he said no.
Let me guess what he said. I'm not having zombies in my house.
Why doesn't he want to help you?
People don't know us, and they're afraid of what they don't know.
Perhaps I should talk to him again.
In Seastone, I thought that success and enough money might make people forget who we are. But they don't. Ever.
You thought thinking... You think that talking to him again would help? I could try. I've got an idea how we could find the heart of the wood.
There should be a lot of psychokinetic energy in the heart of the wood.
What's that?
Well, it's a kind of energy emitted by supernatural things. You can locate it using a little device with arms attached.
Oh.
Could you make a device like that?
Like this?
A little device with arms sticking out. Not exactly a precise description. Can you get me the blueprints? Then Nate and I can try our luck.
Okay.
No, I don't think so.
The mayor has a PKE device. We'll have to wrangle it off him.
If we can't build a PKE detector ourselves, then we're going to have to get hold of the mayor somehow. But he doesn't want to give his up because it reliably detects supernatural beings.
What do you suggest?
I'm working on it. Right then. Hold the fort.
We're here if you need us.
Every time I talk to him, I see that dreadful combination of hope.
Mm-hmm.
Nate has tried time and time again to cheer Timmy up the last few days. He even managed it occasionally. But Timmy always crept back into Esther's coat pocket. The little fellow is hanging on in there. I'm sure he's trying to work out a way to help me. If you could look into that head of his, I'm sure you'd see little cogs whirring around like crazy.
Yes. All right, let's go back into the town. Maybe talking to him again will actually help.
Shop has been nailed up. I'm sure.
One more time.
Hello?
Yes?
About the detector.
Can we talk about the detector again? I really do need it badly to find the heart of the wood.
And I need it to detect supernatural threats around me. As long as the device reliably warns me of any spectral activity, it's an essential companion.
See you again sometime.
I hope so. I really do.
Nah. I don't know. One more time with Gulliver? Otherwise, I'm just gonna try to go in the heart of the wood. I don't know what else to do.
Every time I talk to him.
No.
Nate has tried to.
Oh, we can take this glowing coal?
Touch hot coals with my bare hands. I'd need a really, really good reason to do that.
Here. Put it in the mug.
The stone goblet could easily withstand fire, but what's the point in heating it up?
I want to get the coals with it.
The bedsheet could make the great beginnings of a ghost costume. Ta-da! Time for a ghost performance.
Huh.
Whoa!
Seriously. Whoa! This would be way too easy.
Whoa! Oh!
What are you doing?
Huh?
I am the ghost of the wood.
Haven't we got enough real spooks around here? Do you have to dress up like one too?
Damn.
I don't know what you're talking about. Ooh.
I can see your feet. And is that my bedsheet?
You have unsettled the ghost of the wood, but I will return. Ooh.
That was pretty random.
I don't know how, but he recognized me. It may be because he has a lot of experience with ghostly apparitions, living in the dark woods and all. Or it may have been my feet poking out from under the sheet.
Yeah, and your costume may have stunk. I can't do it again. I want to get the coal with the mug.
Hello.
Oh, our ghost. What was that all about?
I thought a little joke might lighten the atmosphere around here.
Don't joke about ghosts.
I hope so. I really do.
Now that would have been a trick, if you can make his voice sound like that. I want to get that coal. I can't just get it with the mug. Throw the sand on the fire, that would be great. Well, I need to find something to put the coal in, that's for sure. One more time with Gulliver? I don't know.
Gulliver!
Wilbur, how can we help?
I had a great performance as a ghost, but that stupid mayor recognized me.
I dressed up as a ghost! But even though I was totally convincing, that stupid mare recognized me right away.
Yeah, totally convincing.
It was mainly my feet that gave me away.
Then let's use my head to play the ghost.
Oh. There was a reason I kept
Turn
talking to these...
Turn me into a ghost.
There was a reason these people, we talked to these people over and over again.
Gulliver!
Wilbur, how can we help?
Let's go. Time to do some haunting.
Right! Let's do some haunting.
How are we going to do that? Should I roll into the shop?
I could carry you.
A ghost that needs to be carried is no more frightening than a ghost with feet.
That was scary. But I think you're probably right. Right then. Hold the fort.
We're here if you need us.
All right, so what can we do? Take the sheet.
Here's a white sheet to start with.
And? Scary?
Sort of.
Not yet. Sand? A mug?
Every time I talk to him, I see that...
Ugh. Not gonna see it now with a thing on him.
I think Nate has been putting a few more logs on the fire since the attack, and it still doesn't radiate a real sense of security. Touch hot coals with my bare hands. I'd need a really, really good reason to do that. Touch hot...
You have a really good reason to do it.
The stone goblet could easily withstand fire, but... The little fellow is hanging on in there. I'm sure he's trying to work out a way to help me. If you could look into that head of his...
Why don't we put his head on Nate?
Every time I...
I don't know what to do with any of this stuff.
I could make an imprint of the... The imprint would in...
I don't know. Go back in the village. I'm not sure what we can do with the washing line or how we can get it.
I can't reach the knot tying the washing line to the house. Shop has been nailed up. I'm sure there are a few little...
Break the planks. I don't know. Throw sand on the planks. Nothing else I can grab around here? Something on this shelf I can borrow?
I don't think the shop is doing well. Sure, but if the... The mayor wants 10 as soon as... Hello?
No.
See you again sometime.
Maybe I have to go into the woods here.
moment I saw the spooky woods, I just knew I'd end up going in there sooner or later. No matter how afraid I am, I'm sure Timmy and Esther will be even more afraid. Whew.
Okay, so maybe we can find an item in here.
So far, so good. The mayor said that the woods confuse the senses. I have to memorize the way back to the village. And I should try to stay quiet. There's a werewolf, a knight, and perhaps even a headless horseman running around out here.
Hmm. Oh, an axe.
An axe! The wooden handle is all weathered and the iron head covered with a fine coat of rust. It must have been wedged in this tree a long time. Months, perhaps even years.
Take. Oops. Oh! You got it. Good thing you didn't kill yourself with it.
The blade looks reasonably sharp. The tree has kept it from rusting.
Hmm. That's cool.
An old axe. The handle and the parts of the head are very weathered, but the blade is still reasonably sharp.
Just looking. Okay. Let's go. I'm gonna keep track of this. Let's go east. Oh, I came out that way. Bloody scraps of cloth.
That's... oh no.
Whoops.
What is that?
Who'd have thought you can trap gnomes with scraps of bloody cloth?
A werewolf trap! Impressive!
Thanks.
Anytime.
You're a gnome too, aren't you?
You're a sharp one.
Hmm. Have you found any signs of my friends or the attackers?
I haven't found much in the way of traces. You have any better luck?
Some werewolf tracks and footprints made by a heavy person coming from the direction of the cliffs.
Those must be Esther's tracks.
They disappeared in the undergrowth. No traces of a knight, a headless horseman, or any other horrors.
Right.
Perhaps they're ghosts?
Exactly what I thought. Some kind of apparition. Someone is conjuring up all these ghostly figures to try and scare us.
Then we mustn't be scared.
I'm not scared of anything. Well, maybe spiders. I can't stand them.
All right, Ron Weasley.
Sit there waiting, and then suddenly run off and with far too many legs.
Huh. Well, interesting trap. Certainly worked on me.
Clever trap. It got me, that's for sure.
But you're not a werewolf. Razor-sharp senses, and teeth and claws to match. The cage won't keep him for long, and fighting the beast won't be much fun.
Maybe. Maybe it would be better if we carried on together. Then we can protect one another. You know what I mean?
You shouldn't even be here. Go back to the village and wait there for 3 days. If I'm not back by then, leave the dark woods and don't look back.
You can't do that.
No way! I'm not leaving here without Timmy and Esther.
Then at least scream loudly when the werewolf gets you, so I know where to look.
I think that could be arranged.
So you're the first gnome bounty hunter I've met.
Wow! Bounty hunter! That's just so cool! Most of us gnomes tend to be nerdy and avoid the big wide world.
You're here too? And you're some kind of mage?
Well, not a proper one. I'm trying to help my friends. No magic involved. What about you? Did the call of adventure lure you?
Gold.
Oh.
Not my dream job, hanging around in shady inns and taking on missions from greasy characters. As soon as I've gathered enough gold together, I'm going back to the caves, and will hopefully forget most of what I've experienced.
Yeah, enough talk. We have to find my friends.
I have to track down a headless horseman, and I'll kill the werewolf. I haven't crossed that off my list yet. If I stumble across your friend in the process, fine. If not, so be it.
Wilbur!
What?
My name! Wilbur Weathervane! And I'm worried about Timmy and Esther. I want them back undamaged.
I'll see what I can do.
Okay. Look at the trap.
The trap can't be detected underneath the leaves. A good bit of gnome engineering. Complicated and functional. More or less. The bounty hunter hasn't deactivated the trap. Probably hoping for a chance capture. I should stay clear of it. It could be a long time before someone comes to rescue me this time.
Right. Okay, so if I go back this way... and this way... okay. Now, I wonder if we can get the line... oh, we still got the bloody cloth, too.
A blood-drenched piece of cloth as bait for a werewolf. My first thought was that it belonged to Timmy. But it's probably just pig's blood or something like that. At least I hope it is.
I didn't see when we picked this up.
Long sticks are almost as useful as string. You can use them for all sorts of things.
What if we chop down the line? Here we go. That's what I thought about.
If you can't undo a knot, then you can at least cut it. That's it!
He's got it. By Jove, he's got it. Tear-proof washing line.
A washing line about 2 troll strides long and still in pretty good shape.
Tie the washing line on the wooden stick.
The only thing more useful than a bit of string and a long stick is a long stick with a bit of string attached. Fishing rods offer the best of both worlds, and one can do practically anything with them. Like, well, fishing, for example. I built a fishing rod out of the long stick from the woods on a washing line from the village. If I really wanted to go fishing with it, the fish would need to be pretty blind. The washing line is a lot thicker than a fishing line.
Yeah, and plus we haven't come across any ponds or anything like that. Alright, I wonder if any of this stuff... oh, what if we break this?
This might prove useful.
Surprised he doesn't hear that.
I'm looking through the shop here. There's a mirror. And there's the armor and other stuff. Nothing interesting to be seen.
Nothing we can do with all this crap. Okay. Gonna call an episode here. I'm gonna talk with Ghost Gulliver next episode. See if maybe the stuff we found or... maybe we can just stick his head through the boards or something like that and have him scare the mayor that way. Well, thanks for watching as always. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.